Hi guys, welcome back to another video and welcome to my channel if you're new. Hi, my name is Femke and in today's video I wanted to give my shot on the milk bath nail art trend that's been going on for the last couple of weeks. I have seen a ton of different designs made with acrylics, with gel polishes, but none with regular nail polishes on natural nails yet. So that is why I wanted to do just my little take on the milk bath nails. So if you want to know how I made these, please keep on watching. Personally, I'm really happy with how these turned out because this was just my first time trying it just by memory or how I felt like it would work out best. So I just took some of my water decals, which were kind of florally but some fruity ones as well, and some milky nail polishes that I really thought would work well with this design as well. So I already applied a base coat and a top coat on forehand because I was wearing just a neutral manicure, like for the first time in years. But I'm going in with the color 01 Take a Break. This one is from the Essence Color and Care collection. I don't know if it is still available, but you can just pick any opaque, like off-white, milky white kind of color, because this is going to be your base color. It also depends on what kind of finish you would like. If you would like the natural nail to still peek through a little bit, just go with a more light and less opaque nail polish. But I really wanted like my base to be just an opaque clear canvas, not too white though. You could also just go in with an perfect white color, but I felt like this off-white kind of milky white color was really nice to start off as a base. So you just want to apply that to your nails as thick or as thin as you want to. Of course, always keep in mind that if you do apply thin layers, they will dry more quick, like compared to if you would apply thicker layers. But it's totally up to you what works for you personally, like what works best, what your personal preferences are. So I just applied this first layer, making sure to cap off the edge as well, because that's just something that I do to make sure that my manicure lasts for at least a week. You guys know these are my natural nails. I do have like a manual job. I type a lot. I have to pack in specific heavy like stuff at work. I do my household chores myself. So yeah, I do work with my hands, so I have to make sure to cap off the edges. Then I just applied a second layer off camera to make sure that my base was completely opaque and just a nice like smooth base to work on. So on forehand I already cut up some of the water decals that I wanted to use, but before you dunk your decal into the water, make sure to remove the clear film that's on there. If you don't do so, you won't be able to use the water decal because it will be stuck to the clear film and you just simply can't get it off the paper backing. So for each decal, you just want to make sure you keep it into the water for like 15 to 25 seconds. You could just dunk in a whole lot and just pick the ones out you want to use. It doesn't really matter if it stays into the water for a longer period of time. I'd say the longer the better, but it's totally up to you what you prefer and how fast you actually work. Then for all of the decals, I just randomly put them on there. There isn't like a specific order. I mostly wanted to focus on the floral decals and add a little bit of like the fruity decals in there too. I think it just looks really, really cute. But again, it's totally up to you how much or how many or how little decals you want to apply. If you're like, I only want to do like small florally ones, like definitely do your thing, girl. But yeah, I don't really know what else to say. It's really, really easy. You just want to apply all of your decals. It doesn't matter in what order. Maybe you want to apply less. I just dunked on a whole lot because I was like, the more the merrier. And I was just really just doing my thing and just doing my nails and having some fun while at it. I think it's really important to when you do nails, whether it are your own nails as a hobby or even if you are a professional, just feel good about the things you do, take your time, have some fun while at it. I just think that's really important. And it also just shows through your work if you love doing the things you do. They always say that if you do what makes you happy, it isn't like a job or it doesn't feel like work. And I think that doing nails is really like just that to me. Again, I always say like doing nails is like therapy for me. It just calms me down, and this manicure definitely calmed me down. I just think it looks so fun. It looks so lovely, delicate, feminine. I just really, really love it. So I just applied all of the decals to my nails just really randomly. I just smacked a whole bunch on there because, you know, I just like my decals. Then I wanted to go in with an Essence nail polish. This one is from the Shine Last and Go collection. It's a really nice one, but I knew it was quite sheer. So that is why I wanted to use it on top of the decals, because you do want to give it like that milky bath-like effect. And you know, milk baths are like watered down milky colors. You could also go in with a straight white milky color, which I will do after this pinkish layer, because I wanted to warm it up just a little bit with this soft transparent pinky color, but I needed a little bit more coverage to really get that milk bath effect. But it's again totally up to you how you want to do this design, the way you want to. So I just added this first layer. Oh, and there was a little hair on my brush, so I make sure to just get rid of that before applying the polish. If you really want it to be like a pinky milk bath effect, you could easily just go on with just two extra layers of this essence color. But as I said, I'm going to apply a wider, like transparent color afterwards, just to lighten it up a bit. I didn't want it to be like super pink, but I did want it a little bit like more softness and a little bit more warmth, which the pink totally gave. So I'm going in with this Fabi or Fabi color. I only have like 4 nail polishes of this brand, but I knew that this was a really nice like milky color. So here you can see the effect it gives with that extra layer of this white transparent color. I think it really just hits the nail on its head. It's totally milk bath vibe in my opinion, but do let me know what you guys think, if I should have added an extra layer or maybe even less layers. I don't know. I just really love the effect this white transparent polish gave to the entire like milk bath vibe. I really like it. Then again, I'm totally in love with this entire like nail art trend that's been going on for the last couple of weeks. Do let me know in the comments down below what you guys think about this design or like this trend. Is it something for you, or would it be more like something you would do for an accent nail, for like the thumb and the ring finger, for instance? I'm really curious to hear your thoughts about it. I'm just like, I love this so much. I just want it on every single nail. I might even do like a design like this with like gel polishes, and with some real dried flowers, but I don't own those yet, so I have to like order them or just dry some flowers myself. I'm not sure how I'm going to do that yet. I'm not even sure if I'm going to do a design like that with gel like in the first place. I'm still kind of debating on that. But to finish off this design, I felt like it needed a nice layer of clear nail polish. I'm just stumbling today. I don't know what's going on. You could also go in with like a matte top coat or just a regular glossy top coat, but I felt like I just needed a thick, nice, luscious, shiny layer. So I just went in with a clear nail polish by Essence as well. So I usually never really use clear nail polishes, but for this design I really liked it. But yeah, that's already my entire tutorial. Of course you can also recreate this on shorter nails, but of course also on acrylic nails of any length you prefer. But do let me know what you think about this in the comments down below. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. I want to thank you all so much for tuning in on my nail polish collection video as well. So do check that out if you haven't already. And I hope to see you in my next video.